title of Women's Ministry Director, to really emphasize to the district, to, you know, to this district in Illinois, that we are one, we are a body. When you are not a part of the body, we miss that.
Say that, amen.
And I just can't get that evidently through, because, you know, but hey, praise God.
Yes, Lord.
We are here.
Yes, that's right, that's right.
And, you know, I just praise and thank the Lord for each and every one.
Yes, God.
Because, you know, I know that out of our busy time, you know, this is a sacrifice. It is. You know, it's a sacrifice. You know, things that we used to do that were more easy and all that kind of stuff. But, you know, when you give up of yourself.
Yes, God.
And, you know, God honors that. And I want to thank each and every one of you coming and being a part of us. And, you know, it's so good. I've told our people, you know, you got to get out of the box.
Say that.
There is so much more than just your church.
Yeah.
And I haven't had a chance yet to talk to Earl and Denise to find out what they thought about the headquarters when we got here. You know? He says, I have no idea what to expect. He said, what, you know, what is the headquarters?
Yeah.
And so, you know, but it's neat to know, you know, that we do have a place and that you are a part of the place.
Yes, Lord. Amen. Praise God.
And, but it's just good. Just good. And I really do, you know, I do not want you to ever feel like, you know, oh, well, they won't miss me if I'm not there. Yes, we do.
Amen.
Yes, we do. And I love coming so that I can see my brothers and sisters that I don't get to see often. And, you know, I look forward to these times because it's just those rich nuggets and jewels, you know, that's here. And so we're just going to, you know, just continue to partake of those. We can have fellowship over at the lodge. And for those of you who came to spend the night, you know, we're just here. We'll have a good time. Do whatever you want to do and just sit and talk or, you know, go to bed or whatever you, bless your heart.
Amen.
Yeah. I just have a real quick prayer request. Okay. I don't know if you all know news or heard the story of Sahara Baker. She's a little Australian girl that her stepmother, this little girl is 10 years old, beat cancer twice. She lost her hearing due to cancer and lost part of her leg. She came over from Australia with her dad and stepmother, and evidently the stepmother didn't care too much for her, but the mother's
meet here in the morning. It's tough. It's kind of hot.
May I add something, please?
Amen.
Actually, that man is a friend of Abundant Life Pentecostal Church of God Facebook page.
Okay.
Yeah. So see, just he's getting there. You know, when I talk to him, I always say, God bless you for what all you're doing, because this is one man that started this foundation. He didn't know this little girl. He lives in North Carolina. She lived like 3 hours away, you know, but the tragedy of this little girl just struck his heart, you know. He's never met her, never met none of the family or anything. So I thank God, even though my friend says, you know, he's not, that God laid it on his heart to start this foundation for this little girl.
Yes,
and I mean, it hasn't even been a year, and we've got 500 members already.
Yes, God.
You know, and he's helping other children that have to go through the abuse, you know, of just bad things, and it's all on, you know, donations and all that. And I wear her little purple bracelet right here to support her. So just pray for it. Somehow that's the foundation. And that it just continues to grow, and that my flame will just grow up to this
little
season. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. So go have some fellowship. And we're going to have, I think, hamburgers and stuff over there. And just go and eat and enjoy, but most of all, just sit and talk to you. Have fellowship.
Goodbye, guys.